Hello and welcome to FlowTools, an open source project comprised of a series of UI scripts and macros designed to enhance workflows for blind users of Pro Tools. FlowTools macros, triggered by Keyboard Maestro, use scripts to automate tasks while providing orientation and feedback through VoiceOver, dramatically improving efficiency when using Pro Tools. There are currently 120 macros available in FlowTools, and many of those have dual functions. The README file in the FlowTools download includes a list of FlowTools commands and their keyboard shortcuts. My name is Slough Hallaton, and I'll be taking you through the FlowTools commands and demonstrating its features. FlowTools macros are divided into two macro groups within Keyboard Maestro. The first group, simply named FlowTools, contains macros that are available at all times while Pro Tools is the frontmost application. The second macro group, which is inactive by default, is called FlowTools Inspector and can be activated by pressing the / key and deactivated by pressing Shift / Let's begin with the main FlowTools commands within the FlowTools macro group. In Pro Tools, floating windows like the plugin window don't respond to the standard Command W shortcut for closing the frontmost window. When floating windows are open, pressing Command W only affects the mix or edit windows. While Pro Tools does have a hide all floating windows command, which can be useful when you want to temporarily hide windows with the option of reopening them quickly, the shortcut must first be passed through VoiceOver. The Close All Floating Windows shortcut in FlowTools, Command Option W, simply closes all floating windows quickly without the need to pass through the command. FlowTools includes a shortcut for maximizing the mix and edit windows in Pro Tools. Maximizing these windows helps ensure that the maximum number of elements are visible and minimizes the need for scrolling off-screen items into view. It's a good idea to maximize both the mix and edit window when creating a new session or when opening a session created by someone else. Also, using VoiceOver's Describe Size of Item in VoiceOver Cursor command, which is Control-Option-Command-F3, can help when determining when something is off-screen. For example, if VoiceOver reports that a track size is 0 inches wide and 0 inches tall, this means that it's off-screen and that track needs to either be scrolled into view or the window paged or maximized. FlowTools provides shortcuts to identify tracks that are shown and tracks that are hidden. Press Option-Shift-W once, and VoiceOver reports the number of, then speaks the names of the shown tracks.
14 shown, kick audio, snare audio, low tom audio, high tom audio, hi-hat audio, overheads audio, bass high audio, bass low audio, piano audio, sax 30s.
Press Control to interrupt speech if the entire list needn't be reviewed. Press Option-Shift-H once, and VoiceOver reports the number of, then speaks the names of all hidden tracks.
5 hidden, sax 170 audio, guitar calls audio, guitar 460 audio, scratch vocal audio, master 1 master.
One way to remember the letter keys in these shortcuts is to think of the show-hide list, where the W from show is followed by the H from hide. Again, the commands Option-Shift-W for shown tracks, and Option-Shift-H for hidden tracks. When tapped twice in quick succession, the shortcuts for Speak Shown Tracks and Speak Hidden Tracks open the Tracks List pop-up menu. Double-tap Option-Shift-W or Option-Shift-H from any window to open the Tracks List pop-up menu.
Menu, Show All Tracks.
From there, you can access commands like Show All Tracks,
Show Only Selected Tracks, Show Only, Submenu, Hide All Tracks, Hide, Submenu,
etc. While the Speak Shown Tracks and Speak Hidden Tracks commands are helpful in reporting how many tracks are shown or hidden and speaking them by name, the List Shown Tracks and List Hidden Tracks commands take things a step further. Press Control-Shift-W or Control-Shift-H to display shown or hidden tracks respectively in a table where they can easily be reviewed. In addition, tracks in a table can be selected and their status toggled. For example, pressing Ctrl-Shift-W opens a dialog box with a table containing only the shown tracks in a session. To list shown tracks, press Ctrl-Shift-W, and FlowTools opens a dialog containing a list of shown tracks.
Application, 1-4 shown, dialog, 1-4 shown, choose tracks to hide.
Move to and interact with the table and review the list of tracks using VoiceOver.
Table, row 1 of 14, kick audio track, selected. Interact with table, row 1, snare audio track, low tom audio track, high tom audio track, hi-hat audio track, overheads audio track.
If you'd like for all of the listed tracks to remain shown, stop interacting with the table and press the cancel button to exit the dialog. To toggle the status of a shown track in the shown tracks list, in the shown tracks list table, navigate the tracks using VoiceOver.
Bass high audio track, bass low audio track, piano audio track.
When you encounter a track you'd like to hide, stop interacting with the table, then move to and press the hide button.
Stop interacting with table, row 9 of 14, hide, default button. Press Pro Tools, mix, lie to me, mix 1, window, snare, audio track.
FlowTools returns you to the previous window having toggled the track status from shown to hidden. To toggle the status of multiple tracks within the shown tracks list, in the shown tracks list table, navigate the tracks using VoiceOver.
System, application, 1-3 shown, dialog, 1-3 shown, choose tracks to hide. Table, interact with table, row 1, kick audio track, row 1, snare audio track, low tom audio, high tom audio track.
When you encounter the first track you'd like to hide, press Control Option Command Return.
High tom audio track.
VoiceOver plays a sound to indicate the selection. Move to another track you wish to hide and press Control Option Command Return again.
Hi-hat audio track. Hi-hat audio track, added to selection, 2 items selected.
Continue adding tracks to be hidden.
Overheads audio track. Overheads audio track, added to selection, 3 items selected. Bass high audio track. Bass high audio track, added to selection, 4 items selected.
If you wish to remove a track you've added to the selection, navigate to it and press Control Option Command Return again.
Bass high audio track. Bass high audio track, remove from selection, 3 items selected.
Move to and press the hide button to hide the selected tracks.
Hide, default button. Prep Pro Tools, mix, lie to me, mix 1, window, snare, audio track.
The list hidden tracks command and dialog work exactly the same way as list shown tracks does, only the tracks displayed in the table are hidden from the session, and toggling them switches their status from hidden to shown. The list shown tracks and list hidden tracks commands are mostly meant for review purposes, with the added option of toggling the state of perhaps a track or two. When the task involves showing or hiding more than just a few tracks, it might be preferable to navigate the track list table, select all of the tracks you wish to either show or hide, and use the tracks list pop-up menu. Much like the functions for speaking shown or hidden tracks, the Speak Selected Tracks command in FlowTools identifies selected tracks. Press Option-Shift-T once, and VoiceOver reports how many tracks in the session are selected, and then speaks their names.
4 selected, snare audio, bass high audio, sax 37 audio, scratch vocal audio.
Remember, tracks can be selected whether they're shown or hidden. Double-tap Option-Shift-T to deselect all tracks in a session, regardless of their show-hide status.
Deselected all tracks.
Press Ctrl-Shift-T once to list selected tracks in a table. Double-tap Ctrl-Shift-T to list the unselected tracks in a session. These list commands function the same way the list shown tracks and list hidden tracks commands work. The only difference is that rather than using a different letter for selected versus unselected, these use the same letter key and modifiers with a single tap or a double tap. Again, just like the other list dialogs, you can toggle the status of tracks or simply cancel to exit the dialog. Let's take a look at FlowTools' global commands for speaking and toggling the track status buttons, input monitor, solo, mute, and record enable. The shortcuts are Option-Shift-K, Option-Shift-S, Option-Shift-M, and Option-Shift-R, and all of these macros work pretty much the same way. There are a few considerations which we'll cover in a moment. As you might expect, press the command once and VoiceOver reports the number, then speaks the names of the tracks whose respective status buttons are on. Double-tapping the shortcut toggles the status to off on all shown tracks. Let's press Option-Shift-K for input monitor.
To input on, low tom audio, high tom audio.
Double-tapping it.
Turned off input monitor for all tracks.
Let's press Option-Shift-M for mute.
Three muted, piano, audio, guitar 460, audio, Frank, audio.
Double-tapping it.
Unmuted all tracks.
Option-Shift-S for solo.
Two soloed, bass high, audio, bass low, audio.
And double-tapping it.
Unsoloed all tracks.
Keep in mind that in order for tracks to be soloed or record-enabled, they must be shown, but tracks that are hidden can be input monitor-enabled or muted. So, for example, if you double-tap Option-Shift-M, it will unmute all shown tracks. However, if you want to ensure that input monitoring or mutes are turned off on absolutely all tracks in a session, choose Show All Tracks from the Tracklist pop-up menu and then issue the commands. Let's take a look at the Speak Record-Enabled Tracks and Disarm All Record-Enabled Tracks macro. The first half of this macro is currently in beta because its intended functionality is reliant upon how Pro Tools reports the status of Track Record-Enable buttons to VoiceOver. When a Track Record-Enable button is armed, it flashes. Unfortunately, VoiceOver currently only recognizes a record button state as either being on or off, but it cannot detect the fact that the button is flashing. So, in between flashes, VoiceOver sees the button as being off. We're working with Avid to change the way the track record enable buttons are read by VoiceOver. That said, let's describe this command as it's intended to function. Press Option-Shift-R once, and VoiceOver reports how many tracks are record-enabled, and then speaks the names of those tracks.
Six armed, kick, audio, snare, audio, low tom, audio, high tom, audio, hi-hat, audio, overheads, audio.
In its beta state, this command may not report the correct information because, as the script is querying the state of each track, it might perform that part of the script on the track at the exact moment when the flashing track record enable button is in its off state, causing the script to categorize that track as not armed. The higher the number of record-enabled tracks, the higher the likelihood that Flow Tools might encounter a track record-enable button in its off state. Occasionally, Flow Tools might even encounter each of the record-enabled tracks precisely at the moment when they're in the off state. In those cases, Flow Tools simply reports,
"Some tracks are armed."
Pressing Option-Shift-R several times at different intervals will report various numbers depending upon how many tracks are record-enabled. Generally, if Flow Tools reports a higher number around half the time, it's possible that this reported number is fairly accurate, but one shouldn't rely solely upon Flow Tools being accurate until this command is out of beta. For now, a more reliable approach when arming higher numbers of tracks is to select the tracks you wish to arm, check the track selection with the Flow Tools Speak Selected Tracks command, Option-Shift-T, and then press Shift-R, which is the Pro Tools command for arming selected tracks. At that point, it's safe to say that any selected tracks are record-enabled. Although the first half of this macro is in beta, the second half of the macro functions reliably, and that's the Disarm All Record-Enabled Tracks command. Double-tap Option-Shift-R to disarm all record-enabled tracks.
Disarmed all tracks.
Like the List Shown Tracks and List Hidden Tracks commands, the track status buttons have the option of listing tracks whose respective input monitor, solo, and mute buttons are on or off. Press Ctrl-Shift-K, Ctrl-Shift-S, and Ctrl-Shift-M to list tracks whose input monitor, solo, and mute is enabled or on. Double-tap these shortcuts to list the tracks whose input monitor, solo, or mute is disabled or off. Note that only tracks that are shown will be included in these lists. Note also that the Ctrl-Shift-M shortcut for listing muted tracks overrides one of the Pro Tools shortcuts for nudge the selected clip gain back. Use either Ctrl-Shift-minus on the numpad or Ctrl-Shift-comma instead. For exactly the same reasons as discussed with the Speak Record Enable Tracks function, the List Record Enable Tracks and List Record Disable Tracks commands are also in beta. Although we don't recommend their use yet, we've included them simply as placeholders, and they will currently display the tracks that FloTools has identified as either being record-enabled or disabled, but again, these commands are not yet reliable. Use the Speak Record Safe Tracks and Speak Solo Safe Tracks commands to identify the tracks whose record-enable buttons or solo buttons are safe. Press Command-Option-Shift-R once or Command-Option-Shift-S once, and VoiceOver reports and speaks the names of the tracks. Note that hidden tracks might be record-safe or solo-safe, but FloTools will not be able to detect that while the tracks are hidden. To see which hidden tracks are record-safe or solo-safe, choose Show All Tracks from the Tracklist pop-up menu before issuing the commands. Use the Speak Clipped Tracks command to identify tracks whose input stage has been clipped. Press Option-Shift-C and VoiceOver speaks the names of the tracks.
Clipped, music verb, aux, master 1, master.
Use the built-in Pro Tools command, Option-C, to clear all clip indicators.
Clear all clip indicators.
When a record-enabled or input monitor-enabled track achieves meter readings over 0 dB, it engages the clip indicator. Upon playback, however, an audio file cannot exceed the 0 dB ceiling. Because of the existing issue with the track record-enabled flashing, FloTools cannot yet reliably determine whether a track whose peak value equals 0 dB has reached that value upon input or upon playback. Therefore, FloTools assumes that any track whose peak value equals 0 is clipped. So, if you happen to have an audio clip that has been normalized within a track, FloTools will report that track as having been clipped even upon playback. In such a case, clearing all clip indicators with option C will not prevent FloTools from reporting that track as having been clipped because the peak value will continue to read 0 dB until the peak value is reset. Resetting the peak meter will remove that track from FloTools' list of clipped tracks. To avoid having FloTools continue to report that track as having been clipped every time it plays back that particular clip, select the clip and use the clip gain shortcut, Control Shift Down Arrow, to decrease the clip's volume slightly. Note that the Speak Clipped Tracks macro overrides the Pro Tools shortcut for Commit. Use either the Tracks contextual menu or choose Commit from the Tracks menu. Let's take a look at mouse click shortcuts. Pro Tools uses a number of shortcuts that involve mouse pointer clicks along with one or more modifier keys. While it's possible to use a physical mouse or trackpad for these shortcuts, FloTools allows you to use the keyboard to issue modified clicks. In each case, the keyboard shortcut includes the accent key directly above the tab key, while the modifiers are added as necessary. So, for example, to option click an item, simply hold down the option key and press the accent key, or to option shift click an item, hold down the option and shift modifiers and press the accent key. The modified clicks that FloTools supports are as follows: option click, option shift click, command click, shift click, control click, command control click, command option click, command option control click, command shift click, command option shift click, control shift click, control option click, which must be passed through, and control option shift click, which also must be passed through. Note that modified clicks only work on items that are visible. If you attempt to perform a modified click on an item that is off screen, FloTools will alert you by saying,
"Object is outside the window, mix."
If this occurs, use FloTools to zoom the window with Command Option Shift Z or try scrolling the track into view. Let's take a look at some toolbar shortcuts. Most blind Pro Tools users create several VoiceOver hotspots to quickly read the start, end, length, and main counters in the edit window. FlowTools eliminates the need for these hotspots by providing a dedicated set of shortcuts to speak the counters, as well as a number of other numeric displays. The following shortcuts use single and double taps across the F keys with modifiers to speak and edit values, as well as access certain menus. Press Command F1 to speak the value of the start counter.
8 minutes, 20 seconds, 550 milliseconds. Start.
Double tap Command F1 to edit the value.
Type start value.
To enter a value, use the numeric keypad and then press Enter or press Escape to exit without changing the value. Press Command F2 for the end counter.
12 minutes, 52 seconds, 170 milliseconds. End.
Command F3 for the length.
4 minutes, 31 seconds, 619 milliseconds. Length.
Again, double tapping.
Type length value.
To change the length, use the numeric keypad and press Enter or Escape. Command F4 speaks the main counter.
8 minutes, 20 seconds, 550 milliseconds. Main.
Double tapping, of course, allows you to type in a value, and that applies to all of the counters. We're going to skip Command F5, for obvious reasons, and press Command F6.
Bar 251, B2, tick 097, sub.
That's the sub counter. Command F7.
0 minutes, 00 seconds, 010 milliseconds, nudge.
Nudge value. Command F8.
Bar 0, beat 1, tick 000, grid.
Grid value. Command F9.
0 minutes, 02 seconds, 000 milliseconds, pre-roll amount.
And Command F10.
0 minutes, 02 seconds, 000 milliseconds, post-roll amount.
Four of the displays mentioned here also contain menus where you can select format, as well as some presets, and those would be the main counter, the sub counter, and the nudge and grid values. To access the main counter selector, use Command Option F4.
Menu checkmark, min colon sex. Time code, feet plus frames, samples, hide sub counter, bars vertical line beats.
For the sub counter selector, Command Option F6.
Menu checkmark, bars vertical line beats, min colon sex, time code, feet plus frames, samples, checkmark, bars vertical line beats.
For nudge value, Command Option F7.
Menu checkmark, 10 milliseconds, 1 milliseconds, bars vertical line beat, checkmark, min colon sex, time code, feet plus frames, samples, checkmark, follow main time scale.
And for the grid menu, Command Option F8.
Menu checkmark, 1/4 note, 1/8 note, 1/16 note, 1/32 note, 1/64 note, dotted, triplet. Checkmark, bars vertical line beats.
Just a little note that when you edit a pre-roll or post-roll amount, even if you cancel it by pressing Escape, Pro Tools automatically enables the corresponding pre- or post-roll function. If you're only using pre- and post-roll for auditioning purposes, make sure to turn off pre- and post-roll with Command K. FlowTools offers a few commands to quickly report and toggle the following MIDI controls. Press Option 7 on the numpad to speak the status of the metronome button.
Metronome off.
Double tap to toggle its state.
Metronome on.
Press Option 8 on the numpad to speak the status of the count-in button.
Count-in on.
Double tap to toggle it.
Count-in off.
Press Option 9 on the numpad to speak the status of the MIDI merge button.
MIDI merge off.
Double tap to toggle.
MIDI merge on.
Let's have a look at a feature called Plugin Monitor. FlowTools provides control surface users a way to have VoiceOver speak the parameter names and values automatically when navigating encoder knobs or faders when editing a plugin. When a control surface's focus is on a plugin, activating the FlowTools plugin monitor will have VoiceOver speak the parameter value and name whenever a parameter value is changed, either from an encoder knob or a fader in fader flip mode. This is especially useful for those plugins whose control surface mappings differ from the order in which they appear within the plugin window. A good example is the EQ3 7-band equalizer plugin.
EQ3 7-band, plugin selector packet, FXTDM edit view, plugin. Interact with FXTDM edit view, plugin. 36 items, 0.0 dB, input level, parameter. 0.0 dB, output level, parameter, off, phase invert, parameter, high pass type, parameter, out, high pass enable, parameter.
When navigating the parameters inside the plugin window with VoiceOver, the fifth parameter is the high pass enable control. While this parameter appears in the fifth position in the plugin view, on a control surface, depending upon which surface, it is not the fifth encoder or fader, but more like the 28th or 29th parameter. This discrepancy between the plugin window's parameter order and control surface parameter mapping can be confusing and, at best, inconsistent. The FlowTools plugin monitor helps identify the parameter mapping on a control surface and report parameter values that, in some cases, can be changed much more quickly from a control surface than by VoiceOver. With a control surface focused on a plugin, activate the FlowTools plugin monitor by pressing Option forward slash.
Watching plugin, EQ37 band.
Turn an encoder knob or move a fader in fader flip mode, and VoiceOver speaks first the value of the parameter being changed and then the parameter name.
0.67, low band Q. 0.59, low band Q. 0.53, low band Q. 44.3 Hz, low band FREG. 115.7 Hz. 189.1 Hz, low band FREG.
Note that in some cases where a parameter only has two values, the encoder knob or fader has to travel further to move beyond the midpoint of its designated travel before there's a change in the parameter's value.
Peak, low band type. Shelf, low band type.
There are a few things to consider when using the plugin monitor. First, it's not recommended for use without a control surface because while the script is monitoring the plugin parameters for changes, if VoiceOver is used to make a change, VoiceOver will speak the change, and then, having detected the change, FlowTools will instruct VoiceOver to speak the detected change, resulting in VoiceOver repeating itself constantly as parameters are changed. Second, once a plugin has been automated, its parameter values will change automatically according to the automation. FlowTools cannot distinguish between changes being made in real time or by automation, so upon playback, the plugin monitor may become chatty and speak quite a lot, depending upon how many parameters have been automated and how often they're changing. You can temporarily suspend automation or simply deactivate the plugin monitor by pressing Option Shift slash in case you need to cut down on VoiceOver feedback while experimenting with parameters on a control surface.
Deactivate plugin monitor.
Let's move on to the second macro group called the FlowTools Inspector. FlowTools provides a way to speak the status and edit most controls within tracks without the need to interact with the track. Using the FlowTools Inspector, you can do things like review and set input and output paths, or insert and send assignments, read level and peak meters, and toggle controls like input monitor, record enable, solo, and mute, among other functions. To activate the FlowTools Inspector, press the forward slash key.
Inspector on.
Use VoiceOver to navigate to a track, but don't interact with the track.
Tracks. Track lip kick. Audio track.
FlowTools is now focused on the channel strip which contains that track's controls. All of the following commands pertain to the track upon which VoiceOver is currently focused. Press 1 through 0 on the numbers row to speak the inserts and the assignments for those inserts, if any, and whether they're bypassed. Number 1 is insert A.
A. EQ37 band.
Number 2, insert B.
B. DIN3 compressor limiter.
To open a plugin assigned to a particular insert, double tap the number corresponding to that insert. I'm double tapping 2.
Plugin, DIN3 compressor slash limiter, window, track.
If an insert has not yet been assigned, double-tapping its corresponding number is the equivalent of clicking its assign button, which in the case of an unassigned insert, opens the assignment menu.
Menu checkmark, no insert. DSP plugin, submenu. DSP plugin, submenu. E, dynamics, pitch shift, reverb, submenu.
To assign an insert regardless of whether or not it has already been assigned, hold down the command key and press the insert's corresponding number to open the insert's assignment menu.
Menu, DSP plugin, submenu, EQ, submenu, channel strip, EQ31 checkmark. EQ37 band. FFD212 band. Mono. FFD24 band. FFD26. Joe, make me equalize. Mog EQ4. Mono.
A few things to note. First, as mentioned earlier, if inserts are not checked in the Mix Window View's submenu, they will not be visible and FloTools will not be able to speak or edit them. You don't necessarily have to show both sets of inserts, but at least inserts A through E if you have anything assigned there. Second, Command 1 through 7 on the numbers row are shortcuts for selecting Pro Tools edit tools. There are alternative shortcuts located within the F keys, so check the Pro Tools keyboard shortcuts PDF for details about that. Finally, when FloTools Inspector is active, the macro for assigning Insert J, Command 0, overrides the Pro Tools shortcut for Quantize Clip to Nearest Grid. Use the clip menu or deactivate FloTools Inspector with Shift/// to pass through the shortcut. All of the functions described about speaking and editing the inserts applies to the sends as well. The only difference is you add the control modifier. So control 1.
A. Music verb.
Control 2.
B. Bus 5-6.
Control 3.
C. Unassigned.
Command control 3.
Menu checkmark. No send. Output. Submenu. Bus. Submenu. Bus. Submenu. Music verb. Stereo.
Let's move on to input and output. Press the letter I once to speak a track's input path.
A 1.
Double tap the letter I to open the input path selector menu.
Menu, no input. Interface, submenu, interface, submenu, checkmark, a 1, mod, a 2, mono.
Instrument tracks, in addition to an audio input path, have a MIDI input path. Use option I to speak the MIDI input. Double tap option I to bring up its menu. Let's move to output, pressing the letter O.
A 1-2, stereo, greater than a 1-2.
Double tap O.
Menu, output, submenu. Output, submenu, checkmark, a 1-2, stereo, greater than a 1-2.
Instrument tracks also have the additional MIDI output assignment. Use option O to speak the MIDI output assignment, and double tap option O to bring up its menu. Let's move on to automation. The first half of this macro is currently in beta. FloTools cannot yet report a track's automation mode. Pressing the letter A once will eventually speak the current automation mode, but for now, it simply says
null.
Null. Press the letter A twice to open the automation selector menu.
Menu checkmark, red. Touch. Latch. Touch/latch, right.
Press the letter G once to speak a track's current group assignment.
Drum group.
Double tap the letter G to open a track's group assignment menu.
Menu, dimmed. Tracks, submenu, modify ellipsis, duplicate ellipsis, delete ellipsis, hide tracks and group.
Press the letter N once to speak a track's pan setting.
10 to the left.
Double tap the letter N to reset the pan to center.
Centered.
Press the letter K to speak a track's input monitor status.
On.
Double tap the letter K to toggle the input monitor state.
Off.
The same procedure applies to S for solo.
Off. On.
M for mute.
Off. On.
And R for record enable.
Not armed. Armed.
Note that while double tapping R will reliably toggle the record enable status, FloTools may not accurately report the status as it changes. If at any time upon pressing the letter R a few more times to report the record enable status, VoiceOver says armed, the track may be considered armed for recording. Press the letter V once to speak the track's volume fader setting.
Plus 1.0 dB.
Double tap the letter V to reset the volume fader to 0
dB. 0.0 dB.
Let's move over to a different track before taking a look at the meters.
Snare, low, high, high, over, bass, high, bass, low, piano, audio track.
Press the letter L to read the level meter.
No signal.
Let's play the track. And I'm pressing L a few times.
Minus 11 dB. Minus 19 dB. Minus 15 dB. Minus 15 dB. Minus 10 dB.
Double tap the letter L to turn on the level meter monitor.
Watching level meter.
I'm going to play the track.
Minus 11 dB. Minus 19 dB. Minus 15 dB. Minus 10 dB. Minus 30 dB. -16 dB. No level meter.
When the monitor is activated, FloTools monitors the level meter and VoiceOver speaks the level meter as it changes. If you have your preference setting for peak hold set to 3 seconds, VoiceOver will pretty much speak the level meter every 3 seconds, unless there happens to be no change in level. However, if you have the peak hold set to none, VoiceOver will constantly speak the level meter as it changes, resulting in a lot of chatter from VoiceOver interrupting itself. We recommend that you keep the peak hold set to 3 seconds. If you move VoiceOver's focus to another track, the level meter monitor will start monitoring the newly focused track automatically.
-11 dB.
This is monitoring the piano. Now let's move over.
-19, bass low, audio track. -22 dB. -19, -18 dB.
Now it's monitoring bass.
-19 dB. No level meter.
To deactivate the level meter monitor, double tap the letter L.
Deactivate level monitor.
Also, when another window, like the plugin window, for example, opens, it'll automatically deactivate the level meter monitor. Press the letter P once to speak the track's peak meter.
-7.6.
Double tap the letter P to reset the peak meter.
-infinity.
Let's move over to the vocal track before talking about the gain reduction meter.
Sax 3, sax 1, guitar 1, guitar 4, scratch vocal, Frank, audio track.
Before demonstrating the gain reduction commands, I'm going to describe them a little bit. Pressing semicolon once speaks the gain reduction meter. Double tap semicolon to activate the gain reduction monitor. When the monitor is activated, FloTools monitors the gain reduction meter. Since the meter has no peak hold function and the changes in gain reduction can be too rapid to speak, FloTools instead plays a popping sound to indicate gain reduction meter activity. Let's play the track a little. And I'm pressing semicolon.
-3 dB. 0 dB. -1 dB. -3 dB.
Now I'm going to double tap semicolon to engage the gain reduction monitor.
Watching gain reduction meter.
FloTools offers a means to speak the maximum amount of gain reduction achieved over time. When the gain reduction monitor is activated, FloTools keeps track of the maximum amount of gain reduction achieved from the time of activation. Press Shift semicolon once to speak the maximum gain reduction value. Pressing Shift semicolon again has the simultaneous effect of both speaking the maximum gain reduction value and resetting the maximum value. For example, if you activate the gain reduction meter at the beginning of a song and wait until the end to press Shift semicolon, FloTools will report the maximum gain reduction achieved for the entire duration of the song. If you activate the gain reduction meter at the beginning of a song and press Shift semicolon halfway through the song, FloTools will report the maximum gain reduction achieved from the beginning of the song up to the halfway point in the song. If you press Shift semicolon once again at the end of the song, FloTools will report the maximum gain reduction achieved from the halfway point in the song, when you last pressed Shift semicolon, to the end of the song, when you pressed Shift semicolon again. Let's demonstrate speaking the gain reduction maximum a little bit. I'm going to turn on the monitor.
Watching gain reduction meter.
And play a little bit of the track. Now gain reduction is happening, of course, because we hear that popping sound. I'm going to press Shift semicolon.
-7.
So the maximum achieved gain reduction was 7 decibels. Let's press it again, Shift semicolon.
-8.
Okay. Shift semicolon.
-13.
13 dB. It's more than I expected. Anyway.
Deactivate gain reduction monitor.
Like the level meter monitor, if a new window is opened, FloTools will automatically deactivate the gain reduction monitor. Let's press the letter T once.
Frank.
FloTools indicates the track on which VoiceOver is focused. Double tapping T opens the track's pop-up menu.
Menu, hide. Hide and make inactive. Make inactive.
Note that when using the Speak Track Name command, the letter T, if you have the preference to display track numbers checked, FlowTools speaks the track number in addition to the name.
Menu bar, Apple, view, view, menu, track number, checked, 16, Frank, scratch vocal, audio track, 15, scratch vocal, guitar 460, audio track, 14, guitar 460.
This can be helpful when using the scrolled track dialog where track numbers are used. Let's move over to the kick track.
Tracks, track lit, kick, audio track.
I'm going to press the letter C for comments.
D112.
Moving over to the next track.
Snare, audio track.
Pressing C again.
KN84.
Moving over again.
Low tom, audio track.
C.
ND421. High tom, hi-hat, overheads, bass high, bass low, audio track.
Let me press C again.
No comment.
I have no comment in here. Let's edit the comment by double-tapping the letter C. I'm going to turn off the inspector because I'm going to type.
Inspector off. U47.
And pressing return.
Empty scroll area.
Turn inspector back on.
Inspector on.
And reading the comment with letter C.
U47.
By the way, if you're typing in the comments field and don't want it to take effect, simply press the escape key to cancel. I'm going to double tap the letter H to bring up the track options menu.
Menu checkmark, medium, large, jumbo.
Depending upon the track's current height setting, the options available in this menu can change. Press the backslash key under the delete key once to speak the name of a track's current playlist.
Overheads.
Double tap the backslash key to open the playlist menu.
Menu checkmark, overheads. Other playlists. New ellipsis. Duplicate ellipsis. Delete unused ellipsis.
Press the letter F once to speak a track's freeze status.
Frozen.
Double tap to toggle the freeze state.
Not frozen.
The first half of the speak slash select track view macro is still in beta. Double tap the W key.
Menu checkmark, waveform.
To bring up the track view pop-up menu.
Volume. Volume trim. Mute.
The first half of the speak slash select elastic audio macro is also in beta. Double tap the letter E.
Menu checkmark, none, disable elastic audio.
To open the elastic audio plugin menu.
Polyphonic, rhythmic, monophonic, vary speed, X form, rendered only, checkmark, none, disable elastic audio.
Press the letter B once to speak a track's time base.
Samples.
Double tap the letter B.
Menu checkmark, samples.
To bring up the time base menu.
Ticks. Checkmark, selection changes alternate playlists. Checkmark, samples.
Well, that completes the FlowTools inspector commands as well as this overview of FlowTools in general. That was a lot to get through. You can download FlowTools at flowtools.github.io. That's FLOTOOLS.GITHUB.io. There you'll find more information about FlowTools and keep up with updates. Thanks so much for listening, and we hope FlowTools helps you make the most out of your Pro Tools workflow.